Oh, I wonder why my coffee tastes so bad today.
Oh, hi, Fanta. What's going on?
Hey, Shelly. My coffee doesn't taste good at all today.
Oh, really? Let's see. Ah, you are too sleepy today and used the wrong coffee size.
Oh, how does the coffee size affect the coffee taste?
Let me help you find out. Let's grind some coffee to figure out how its particle size affects its taste. Let's go.
We chose the roasted Arabica coffee beans from Yunnan, China, to perform this little experiment. First, we will need to grind the coffee beans into different sizes using a coffee grinder. Take a closer look at the ground coffee from the grinder. We can see that different grinding settings in the grinder produce coffee particles of various sizes. Divide the ground coffee into four categories according to their particle sizes. The coffee particles are getting smaller and finer going from the left to right. These four coffee grinds are defined as coarse, medium, fine, and extra fine. Let's brew the coffee to see how coffee particle sizes affect the taste. For this specific type of coffee beans, it is recommended that for 8 grams of coffee, 140 milliliters of water is used for a perfect brew. To ensure that the only factor affecting the taste of brewed coffee is the particle size, we control the mass of ground coffee around 8 plus and minus 0.1 grams for all four grinds. And the water temperature is maintained at 90 degrees Celsius. A balance is set up to control the amount of water used to brew the coffee is around 140 milliliters. Repeat the brewing steps for all four grinds. Next, we'll weigh the brewed coffee to compare the extraction level of each grind. We can see that the coarse size produced the most brewed coffee, while the extra fine size produced the least. After brewing, the leftover coffee grounds look different. The coarse and medium coffee particles are still distinguishably separated from each other. In contrast, the fine and extra fine particles aggregate and tend to move to the bottom part of the filter.
Ta-da! Look at all the different sizes of coffee that are brewed.
Interesting. I see different sizes of coffee already. What are we going to do with it?
We are going to measure the particle size of these coffees.
Measure? You mean with this?
Nah, we are going to use the better size 2600 with dry dispersion unit to measure the particle size of these coffees.
Interesting. Can't wait to find out.
Let's head into the better size lab to do some fun experiments.
Let's go.
The instrument we use to investigate the coffee particle sizes is the Better Sizer 2600 with the dry dispersion unit. Employed with the unit Fourier and inverse Fourier optical systems, the Better Sizer 2600 is the laser particle size analyzer that provides accurate measurement results for particles with sizes ranging from 0102 to 2600 microns. The Better Sizer 2600 is compatible with both the dry and the wet dispersion units. Today, we are using the dry dispersion unit to measure the particle sizes of different coffee grinds. First, we need to add some coffee samples in the funnel, which will send the samples to the vibrating filling tray where measurement starts. Then, operate the software on the computer by entering the sample's information and click Start Measurement. Repeat the procedures for all four coffee grinds. Here are the particle size distribution curves obtained from the Better Sizer 2600. As we can see that the particle sizes of coffee decrease when the grinds are moving from coarse end to finer end. The D50s of coarse, medium, fine, and extra fine grinds are around 1100, 600, 300, and 60 microns, respectively. The results demonstrate the ability of the Better Sizer 2600 in monitoring the particle sizes of ground coffee. To closer examine the extraction level of brewed coffee from different grinds, we measure each brewed's total dissolved solid level. If the TDS number is higher, it indicates that more soluble contents in the coffee bean are extracted out in the brewed coffee. As shown in the table, TDS values increase as grinds move from the coarse to fine ends. With that being said, finer coffee grinds produce brew with higher extractions, leading to a stronger flavor.
Now I see Better Sizer 2600 is really amazing.
Yeah, now you know why different sizes of coffee affect your taste.
Now I got it.
Did you know that different sizes of coffee need different brewing method? For the coarse one, we will want to use cold brew. For the medium one, we can use French press or aerial press. Where did she go?
Yeah.